Anybody believe there's a blessing in the house tonight? Come on, anybody believe there's a blessing? Come on, somebody say it's in the house today. Say it's in the house today.
There's a blessing in the room today. Are you ready? Get ready. It's already.
Well, greetings. This is Pastor Ian with Kingdom Builders, and I want to say thank you for your time. I want to talk to you about a few things that are vitally important. Right now, we're in the midst of what we call our 30 for 30 capital campaign drive. That's right, where we're believing God for $30,000 over the next 30 days. That's $1,000 a day. That's right, you heard me. Let me say it again, $1,000 per day for the next 30 days. Our faith is out there. We want you to be in faith with us. When I look at the Gospel of Acts, when I look at Acts, the Acts of the Apostles around chapter 4, there's a wonderful story in there talking about the people of God being assembled together in one place. They had the same heart, and one mind, one soul. They were together after being filled with the Holy Spirit. The Bible lets us know that they came together. No man looked down on the things of somebody else, but they had all things in common. They went out and sold land, sold their possessions, brought them and laid them at the apostles' feet for the distribution of those that were in need daily. And the Bible tells us that there was nobody that had any lack. Why? Because they had the same mind. They wanted to see the kingdom advance. What are you saying, Pastor Ren? I'm not telling you to go sell possessions. I'm not telling you to go sell land. If God tells you to do that, you do what God says. But what I am saying is giving is not just about what's in my hand. Giving is ultimately about what's in my heart, because there must first be a willing mind and a willing heart, because that is acceptable to the Lord. We're in the midst of this capital campaign drive. We are stretching our faith. I challenge the people of God here that we cover to make sure we make sizable investments, not just into brick and mortar, but into the lives of people. I got an opportunity to talk to one of my uncles from New York, and he ministered to me this past week. He was sharing some things with me as it relates to kingdom work. And one of the things he said is, you cannot put a price on a soul. That kind of stuck with me. He says, you can't put a price on a soul, because what you all are doing as kingdom builders, there is a place where people can come and be refueled, be energized. They can become, get edified so that they can leave the four walls and be equipped to go and evangelize their communities. Well, guess what? When souls come in and get saved, that's an investment that's made into their lives. When you create an atmosphere or a place where people can come, bodies can get healed, it's a safe zone for people to come and get delivered. Guess what? You can't put a price tag on that. And so you have to have like-minded people that understand that the kingdom is not just about me, it's about we. We want to do something, create a place where people can come from all walks of life, and they can come, feel comfortable where they are, and then they can lead change. I want to say this to you. I believe this with all of my heart. I've been convicted, and I'm convinced that this community needs, as we call it, KBB. Thank God for what we've been able to do over the last 5 years, and we're approaching our 6th church anniversary coming up in June. But there's so many other things that God has laid on our heart. The vision is still there. And what I've learned about vision, if it's a vision from God, even when the leader dies, the vision continues to live. And so I want to encourage you today. Will you partner with us? I'm not asking you, unless God lays it on your heart, to give the entire $30,000. But I want you to be in faith with us. Number one, be in faith that resources, as we say on Sundays and Wednesdays, unexpected and unexplainable resources are coming from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. Be in faith with us that God is going to perform his word. I'm believing God that as we sow collectively, that there is a speedy return that will come on our investment. Might I suggest to you that you don't lose every seed that you've sown when you've sown it into the kingdom. All it did was you've loaned it into your future. It was an investment into your future, into the life of somebody else. And so I want to encourage you, as you're considering sowing today, this is what we call sacrificial giving. It's going above and beyond so that we can see somebody else blessed. Would you consider doing that? The information is on the screen. It's right there, the ways to give, whether through Cash App, Givelify, Text to Give, or if you want to mail in your contributions, whatever method works for you, the information is right there. There it is. Our 30 for 30 flyer is there. So you see exactly what we're doing. We believe that this is going to be a place that's going to change lives. Can I say this? As we are thinking globally, it's our responsibility to act locally. And I love it because that's one of our bedrock principles, and that is we reach upward toward God, inward toward each member, outward toward our community, and downward toward the brokenhearted. And so I'm grateful to God for your time, but I want you to prayerfully consider sowing over the next 30 days into Kingdom Builders. I believe it's good ground, and my wife and I have already made some pledges. We've already begun giving. We had to lead by example, and I thank God for the members that have begun to sow as well. So we're counting on you. We are Kingdom Covenant Partners, and I'm looking for God to do the impossible in your life as well as send that overflow of blessings. I love you, and we're praying for you. Thank you in advance for what you've done, what you're doing, and what you're going to do. We are building the kingdom together, one person at a time. Let's keep building.
Come on, anybody believe there's a blessing? Come on, somebody say it's in the house today. Say it's in the house today. There's a blessing in the room today. Are you ready? Get ready. It's already been released.